Welcome to all grade 9s to our first term 2 2020 online mathematics class. In this lesson, we are going to do some revision of algebraic expressions covered in grade 8. The prior knowledge we expect each pupil to have include knowledge of numbers, operations and relations, number patterns, functions, exponential laws, fractions, and decimal fractions. Learning outcomes. So the objectives of this lesson will be, by the end of this revision lesson, you should be able to demonstrate knowledge of the following. Number one, you should be able to show understanding of an algebraic expression, the part of an algebraic expression, variable term, constant, parts of a term, and polynomials. So here you see these are actually the definitions that we will be using, and you need to know when to use them and use them in a proper manner. Two, should be able to distinguish between like terms and unlike terms. You should be able to multiply two monomials. You should be able to simplify a monomial raised to a further power. You should be able to divide two monomials. And six, you should be able to divide a polynomial with a monomial. Right, now, we have done the simple operations of grouping like terms. Now, let's do some multiplication. Right, so let's do the simplest of all. These ones you can apply even the complex one. Remember, with mathematics, we start with simple operations, and then we give you some challenging complex operations. So you grasp the principle by looking at simple operations like multiplying two monomials. How do we multiply two monomials? So let's work with multiplying two monomials, 2y multiplied by 3y. This can be written mathematically as 2y multiplied by 3y, or 2y dot 3y still multiplication. 2y open bracket, 3y close bracket, still multiplication. 2y open bracket, 2y close bracket, 3y still multiplication. Open bracket, 2y close bracket, open bracket, 3y close bracket. It's all multiplication. That is, those are the different ways how we write our mathematical expressions. Now, step number one when multiplying coefficients, monomials, is you multiply the coefficients. First, you multiply the coefficients. Here we are multiplying 2 multiplied by 3 gives you a 6. And then you take the variables again, you multiply them. We've got a y multiplied by a y. Using the laws of exponents, we say that, remember, that y has got an exponent of 1, not 0. Remember, even though we don't write the exponent, we must know that it's there. If there was a 0, it would have been a 1. But since there is a y, then the exponent is 1. So when we multiply two variables which are equal or which are the same, we add the exponents. So it's going to be y to the power of 1 plus 1, which is y squared. And then step 3, you multiply the product of step 1 with that of step 2. So you are going to take the 6 and then you multiply it with y squared. Then you get your final answer, which will be 6y squared. In summary, what are we saying? So when you are given 2y multiplied by 3y, you say 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by y multiplied by y, which gives you 6y squared. Now, let's pause here, and please, can you go to page 95, do a revision exercise, simplify those two questions. Right, next, we're going to be looking at steps when simplifying a monomial raised to a power. Right, so we are going to look at this monomial, which is open bracket negative 2a to the power of 5 close bracket to the power of 4. Step number 1, we separate each exponent by distributing the exponent into the brackets. Leave each component in its own bracket. So we distribute the exponent like that. So step number 2 is that we evaluate the signs using the fact that if we've got a negative sign and it is raised to an even exponent, that will equal a positive exponent. And if it is a negative sign and it is risen, it is raised to the power of an odd exponent, so the negative exponent remains negative. So in our case, we've got that negative exponent raised to the power of 4, that will become a positive. Step number 3, we raise the power of the remaining component by using the laws of exponents. Now, we are going to say 2 to the power, in brackets, to the power of 4. Remember that 2 has got an exponent of 1. So we write it like that just for everyone to understand what exactly happens, is that we multiply the exponent with the exponent outside the bracket. So we raise the different components to the power 4. So that 2 becomes 2 to the power of 4 and a becomes a to the power of 20. So 2 to the power of 4 becomes 16. So again, for practice, let's go to the same exercise on page 95, revision exercise, and simplify C8, C9, C10, C11, and C12 as practice. Remember, this is still revision to make you, with just getting you up to speed so that you remember what you might have forgotten. Now, let's look at steps to follow when dividing monomials. So when we are dividing monomials, we are going to take a monomial. Let's divide 12b to the power of 7 by 3b squared. So this can be written mathematically as 12b to the power of 7 divided by 3b squared, or open bracket 12b to the power of 7 close bracket divided by open bracket 3b squared close bracket, or it can be written as 12b to the power of 7 divided by 3b squared. Step number 1. So the step number 1 is that what we need to do first is always state the restrictions of the denominator. These restrictions, remember, we are dealing with variables, and variables can take any value, but when it is a denominator, it cannot take any variable. That value which makes it equal to 0 is a restriction, which means it cannot be equal to that particular value, because remember, division by 0 is not a real number, or in layman terms, it's undefined. So 12b to the power of 7 divided by 3b squared will be true if and only if b is not equal to 0, because once b becomes 0, we are dividing by a 0, which is not a real number. Now, step number 2, divide the numerical coefficients using the integer rule. So the integer rule, we are just going to be using the integers 12 divided by 3, which gives you a 4. Step number 3, divide the exponents using the laws of exponents. So now we're going to divide the variables using the laws of exponents. So which is b to the power of 7 divided by b to the power of 2. When the bases are the same and we want to divide, we are going to subtract the exponent. So it becomes b to the power of 7 minus 2 is b to the power of 5. Step number 4, multiply the answer of step 2 with that of step 3 and leave your answer with positive exponent. This will assist you whenever you are dealing with exponential expressions, right? So it becomes, now the product of step 2 was a 4, the product of step 3 was a b5. You multiply them together, they give you that. In summary, what are we saying? So that is what exactly happens. Again, let's do some practice on page 95, revision exercise. Answer those two questions, E1 and E2, as practice. Right. The next thing that we are going to be looking at now is dividing a polynomial by a monomial. So we're going to be dividing 8a to the power of 5, b to the power of 1, c multiplied by 24a cubed, b, c to the power of 4, minus 16ab, c to the power of 6, c squared by 4a. Right. So those are the different ways in which we can write that expression. Now, moving on, step 1, always state the restrictions, just like in the previous slide, you state the restriction of the denominator. Remember, in this case, we must not make sure that the denominator is not equals to zero. So if A is zero, the denominator becomes zero. If B is zero, the denominator becomes zero. If C is zero, the denominator becomes a zero. So A cannot be equals to zero. So will B and C. They all three may not be equals to zero. That is the restriction. Step two, divide each of the terms in the numerator, right, with numerator, that is the polynomial, with the monomial denominator, right? So each term in the numerator polynomial with the monomial denominator, like that. So each term in the numerator is divided by the monomial. And then step three, we simplify using the previous rule of dividing monomials. So this becomes the answer. So in summary, those are the steps again. So please take your time. Don't rush through the slides. Please take your time, study the slides, and then you have got some practice questions to do. This is revision, remember. So go to page 95 again, revision exercise. Answer E3, E4, and E5. Right. Now, we are going to be looking at rules for determining square and cube root of an algebraic expression. So the rules that we use are given below. We have got, if we are given square root of x, it can be written as x to the power of half. Square root of y to the power of b can be written as y to the power of n all over 2. And cube root of a can be written as a to the power of 1 all over 3. Cube root of n to the power of x can be written as n to the power of x all over 3. Right. Now look at these questions. Can you simplify them? Please pause before you look at the answers. So this is just for practice. So there are the answers. Please, you can pause or you can go one by one. I hope you did it yourself first before you looked at the answer. Anyway, there is more practice questions which you can do. These are the questions which I want you to do now for practice. You go for practice to page 95 and 96, revision exercise, you do E6 and you do F7 to F12. I hope you managed to understand what I was trying to teach you in this lesson of ours. Remember, with those objectives at the beginning, I hope you are able to answer all those objectives at the end of the day. So this is the background which we are going to take with to now go and do what you are expected in algebraic expressions for grade 9 2020. Thank you. Enjoy the rest of your day.